What is the probability that divisor of 10 raised to 99 is a multiple of 10 raised to 96? So to find that probability, you know that you have to find the ratio between total number of favorable outcomes divided by total number of outcomes. So here the question is to find the probability that a divisor of 10 raised to 99 is a multiple of 10 raised to 96. So in the denominator, you must have total number of outcomes, which is total number of divisors of 10 raised to 99 or total number of factors of 10 raised to 99. Both are same. In the numerator, you have to find number of factors of 10 raised to 99, which are multiples of, along with that, it must be a multiple of 10 raised to 96. It must be a factor of 10 raised to 99. Along with that, it must be a multiple of 10 raised to 96. That is what you require in the numerator. So this is the basic idea of this problem. So your objective is to find the number of factors of 10 raised to 99, and you have to find the number of factors of 10 raised to 99 which are multiples of 10 raised to 96, right? So how to find the number of factors of, or rather the number of divisors of, how to find the number of factors of a particular number? Suppose I take the number 12. 12 has got these numbers as divisors. Because when you divide 12 by any of these numbers, you will not get a remainder, which means that these are divisors of 12, or rather these are factors of 12. The thing is, in case of 12, I can directly find these numbers because 12 is a very small number. Whereas for 10 raised to 99, I need to find the number of factors of 10 raised to 99, right? Now 12 can be written as 2 square into 3. These are the prime factors of 12, right? 2, 3 are the prime factors. 2 raised to 2 is 4. 4 into 3 is 12. How did I get 1? 2 and 3 I have written here. 0, 1, 2. I have 2 to the power of 2. Whereas 3 to the power of 1. Right. Now, how did I get 1? Because already I have a 1 here. That is what I am telling. Already I have a 1 here. So, I don't take 2s and 3s. I take only 1. Right. So, I get 0, 0. If I take 0, 2s and 0, 3s, I get 1. 1 is a divisor of any of those numbers in the number line. So, 1 obviously is a factor. Now, if I take 1, 2, right? If I take 1, 2 and 0, 3s, I get the number 2. If I take 2, 2s and 0, 3s, I get the number 4. Because if I take 2, 2s, 2 into 2 is 4. Now, if I take 0, 2s and 1, 3, I get the factor 3. If I take 1, 1, I get 6, and if I take 2, 1, I get 12, which means that I am actually multiplying the number of, because I can, by the basic principle of counting, I know that if I can take 1 from here and 1 from here, I'm going to multiply it. So I'll be having 6 different options. I can take either 0, 0 or 0, 1 or 1, 0 or 1, 1 or 2, 0, 2, 1, which means that 3 into 2. 6 will be the number of factors that I have, or 6 will be the number of divisors that 12 has got. In the same manner, I can find the number of divisors of 10 raised to 99, right? I can factorize it, and applying the same logic, I can find the number of factors of 10 raised to 99. Followed by that, I have to find the factors of 99, which are multiples of 10 raised to 96. Now, 10 raised to 99 can be written as 2 raised to 99 into 5 raised to 99. Of course, there is a 1 there, right? There is, of course, a 1 which I have written. So, I can take 0, 0, or I have 100 different options. Earlier, in the case of 12, I had 3 options for 2 and 2 options for 3, which means that I multiply these two things to find the total number of divisors of 12. So in the case of 10 raised to 99, I can have 100 options in case of 2. I can leave 2, which means that I don't take any of those 2s. I can take 1, 2, 2, 2s, 3, 4, 5, 6, up to 99, which means that I have 100 different options for 2, and again 100 different options for 5. So total number of divisors of 10 raised to 99 will be 100 into 100, which is 10,000, right? Now, 10 raised to 96 is 2 raised to 96 into 5 raised to 96, in the same manner. Also, I can write 10 raised to 99 as 10 raised to 96 into 2 raised to 3 into 5 raised to 3. I have written this thing like this. Now, the question is, I want to find those multiples of 10 raised to 96 which are divisors of 10 raised to 99. That is what I have to write in the numerator. So, if I take 10 raised to 96 into 3, this is of course a multiple of 10 raised to 96. But that is not a divisor of 10 raised to 99 because 3 is not a factor of 10 raised to 99, right? So I have to multiply with those numbers which the entire system must be, the entire multiplied number must be a factor of 10 raised to 99, right? So the options that I have is I can take various combinations of 2 raised to 3 and 5 raised to 3, I mean 2 and 5, so that will be a factor of 10 raised to 99, because 10 raised to, in the same manner that we have written here, all that I have to ensure is that I cannot take all the options of 2 and 5. Instead, I have to make sure that 10 raised to 96 remains as such, followed by any combination of 2 raised to 3, 5 raised to 3 must be a factor of 10 raised to 99, right? So what I can say is, out of these 2 raised to 3 and 5 raised to 3, I have 4 options for 2 and 4 options for 5. Because I can either choose 0 2s and 0 1s, which means that my factor will be 10 raised to 96, which is, I mean, the first number will be 10 raised to 96, which is of course a multiple of 10 raised to 96 and a divisor of 10 raised to 99. Now if I go for 1 2 and 2 5s, so 1 2 means 2, 2 5s means 25. So into 10 raised to 96 into 50, 10 raised to 96 into 50 is of course a multiple of 10 raised to 96. And of course, it is a factor of, right, of course, it is a factor of 10 raised to 9, or rather a divisor of 10 raised to 99. So what it means is that those numbers which are multiples of 10 raised to 96 and divisor of 10 raised to 99, the total number of numbers will be 4 into 4, right? I have 4 options for 2 and 4 options for 5, which means that 16 numbers will be the number of favorable outcomes. So 16 divided by 10,000 will be the required probability. So 4 by 100 is 1 by 25 into 1 by 25, which is 1 by 625. So my answer must be 1 by 625.